It's just that my brain, dude. Guys, what up? Welcome back to a very, very, very special Sobras episode. It's been way too long, my dudes.
Yeah.
How y'all doing today, guys?
I'm doing good.
Yo, hola, morras y morros.
You guys already know, if you're not familiar with the Sobras episodes, they're basically like leftovers, you know? Like when you bought too much pizza and you have three extra slices for lunch tomorrow. That's what this is, you know? Today we're joined by a very special guest.
Who's that?
Everybody help me in welcoming our boy, Javi! Yay! What up, Javi? How you doing?
Pretty good, man. How about you?
Oh, you know, chilling like a villain.
Yeah.
Sorry. but yeah, man, how you doing? How you feeling? You ready to get in on this?
Yeah, let's do it.
Because we're going to ask you a lot of tough questions.
Go for it, man.
We're going to ask you all about your personal life and, you know, your professional life and...
Hell yeah.
Things you didn't want to have answered.
Hay que entrarle primero.
Oh, yeah. Sorry.
Oye, Javi, ¿tú no tomas tanto monstruo? Yo creo que has tomado más monstruo en estos días que en toda tu vida.
We've indoctrinated you. All right, three, two, one, pop. Ooh. This is America. Look how we sipping up. Police be tripping up. Mickey, you were right. I slowly get closer and closer to the mic.
Y luego me empiezo ya me acerqué para allá para bajarle.
No, but now I'm aware.
Why did
now
you
I'm
do
aware.
This?
I'm sorry. So yeah, today we don't have too many things scripted. It's kind of like off the cuff.
Yeah, we just want to get to know who is Javi.
Javi,
the man behind the Beamer.
Can we? Oh yeah, dude. Yeah, you have a pretty sick car, dude.
Oh, thank you, man.
I see a lot of anime stuff on it, though. And, you know, some anime waifus on the windshield and whatnot.
Yeah.
Oh, hey. Dude, you haven't seen all of it yet.
Bro.
Yeah. Para los que están escuchando, Plebes, el Javi estuvo aquí en el episodio que grabamos del miércoles. Ahí estaba nomás sentado, pero lo habíamos invitado para grabar este episodio, ¿no?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Pero él estuvo ahí nomás. ¿Cómo se le puede decir?
Observing.
He was in the background. Well, the thing is that he didn't have a microphone ready because... Damn it, Alex!
Yeah. Pero, ¿cómo se dice cuando estás hovering ahí nomás?
Yeah. He was just above us. He was, well, you're trying to find the right word for it?
Sí, nomás como...
He was in the room. He was a ghost.
I was the ghost, bro. The ghost.
The ghost.
¿Qué es eso? Like a ghost. ¿Es una forma rara de decir ghost?
Yeah.
Is that the simp way?
The simp way.
Actually, we even made a sound clip just for Alex. Where is it? Here it is.
Stupid.
That's it. And this was Mickey. Mickey made sure. He's like, Husky, I need this now. Okay, and I was like, all right.
Amazing. Listen, Alex, we don't hate you. We love you.
Yeah, we do.
We want you to do better, though.
Yeah.
So we're taking away your privileges, all of them, every single one, even your food privileges. They're gone. So until you get back on track, you can eat again.
Okay. Oye, Javi, ¿cuántos años dijiste que tienes?
19.
19 años.
Dude.
¿Quieres decir que eres un adúltero?
No. Sí, pero no.
Ya tiene peluches en la cajuela.
Pero,
¿qué no? Ya tiene peleas en el coliseo. Oye, ¿de dónde eres tú?
San Diego.
Ah, creí que eras de China, pero también.
San Diego. What? Wait, China?
Why did you think that?
I mean...
Why? He doesn't look Chinese at all.
No, nadie te decía chino cuando estabas morrito.
La verdad, sí.
La neta, sí. Te decían el chino. Ahí viene el chino. ¿No se te figura que es chino cuando lo miraste la primera vez?
They thought I was Korean in middle school.
¿Que tú eras coreano? Yeah. Eso no me lo puedo imaginar.
I don't even believe that.
Okay, well, hold on. How about now?
I mean, o sea, ahora que me lo dijiste tú,
right?
Puedo verlo, no, pero no se me había ocurrido a mí por mi propia cuenta. Pero el Javi de volada cuando lo vi dije, este morro es coreano.
For real? I definitely thought Mexican immediately first thing. I was like, Sarah, yeah,
look at your camera right now.
Stare at your camera.
It's this one right here.
Oh, okay.
Deep. Mira coreano, gana.
Stare deep into that.
¿Cómo estoy diciendo? ¿Qué?
Oh my god.
Tienes 19 años. Oye, eres un eres ¿cómo le llaman? A car connoisseur. Aquí
hola. He's a gearhead.
¿Te gusta mucho andar metiéndole mano a los carros?
Sí. A todos mis carros.
¿Pero tú le metes mano tú mismo o nomás estás bien traumado con tener un carro que se mire bien perro?
All the way inside of his car.
I was dependiendo, waiting for it.
Dependiendo en el carro, como si es un carro nuevo and I never had it before, sí. Then I'll take it to someone, have them do the work, and then I'll learn from it.
Learn from them.
Nice.
Pero sí te gusta meterte en la mecánica tú mismo.
This dude has a pretty sick Beamer, and I know he's done some upgrades to it. What kind of upgrades have you done to it that you've done yourself?
Nothing besides just brakes.
Really?
Yeah.
No suspension?
The car is stock right now.
Lie.
No.
For real?
I'm dead ass.
Dude. Well, sick.
Getting some new coilovers pretty soon.
Oh, okay. You know? So you did talk about getting coilovers.
Oye, yo cuando estaba morrito, nunca era de esos morros que estaban clavados con eso de los carros, ¿no? Como los morros que conocen cualquier carro que pasa por la calle, ¿no?
They can hear it.
Ándale.
They can hear the car and be like, oh, yeah, that's
o le
super.
Miran, o está de noche y le miras las luces, cómo...
The car that I first fell in love with when I was younger was a Chevy Camaro.
Camaro. ¿Sí? Wait, the Bumblebee Camaro?
Yeah. The Bumblebee.
¿Ese específicamente? Yeah. ¿La versión vieja en la película o la versión...
Oh, that's true. Which one?
Well, I'll give it to the old one.
It had to be the new model. Let's see. Let's find it.
I believe it was a 2010, though.
2010.
Oh, tú hablas de nuevo. Porque en la película de Bumblebee, de la película de Transformers, Bumblebee fue un Camaro viejo primero, como de los 70, sería.
71, 72.
I like the old school ones, but I'll lean more towards
the newer ones.
Oye, qué loco que cuando se trata de carros, hay carros específicamente como este. Y entre todos los morros siempre... ¿Hay un carro bien amado o bien odiado?
Oh,
¿sí o no?
Yeah, big time.
¿Verdad? Y yo siento como que este es uno de ellos.
I feel like every car in the world is either, like, it has both.
Pero solamente entre los morros que conocen de carros, ¿no?
I don't think there's a car...
Between the Camaro, the Mustang, and the Challenger, you're gonna hate two of them, but you're gonna love one.
Oh, okay, sí.
Yeah.
Y en las trocas también, en las trocas como la Chevy, la Ram y la...
Yeah.
And la Ford.
Remember that car that I told you that I saw? It's a Dragon Ball Z Super wrapped.
Yeah.
And it was a pink one. It's actually a Camaro. Model, the 2010. Like this
one, the 2010 is actually one of the most reliable ones out there.
Yeah.
And if you're looking for a Camaro on the market,
yeah,
that's your best choice.
Yo como alguien que no está traumado con carros ni nada, cuando vi este carro me gustó mucho. Y a mí ni me llama la atención los Camaros. O sea, no.
La razón por la cual a mí me gusta más ese... In vez de like a Mustang or a Challenger, is because it's not only does it have the aggressive look on it,
yeah,
but you get the sportiness out of it.
I actually rented, when we went to California, because one of my friends auditioned for The Voice and we had to rent a car, they gave us a Challenger. It's a nice car, but it was annoying because the windows are so tiny. It was hard.
It's limited visibility.
And at the same time, I always was worried that I was going to hit somebody. Because even where we stayed at the hotel, it was underground and everything was so tight space that I was the whole time just worried that I was going to damage this car or hit somebody.
Although the new Camaros also have really bad visibility.
They do. Yeah. Actually, the new Camaros are the only cars that have the worst visibility out of all of them.
Yeah.
I think if we're going to go Camaro, Mustang, or are we saying Challenger or Charger?
Challenger.
Okay, so...
No, the Charger is damn fast.
Camaro, Mustang, Challenger. I'm gonna go with Mustang. That's gotta be that's
why?
For me.
Just, para ti personalmente,
just because, I don't know. It's the one that appeals to me the most.
The old models.
A mí me cagan los Mustangs.
I like the new ones, too. Like,
if we're talking about an older model, then
of course you're gonna go straight to the Eleanor.
No,
ese Mustang se mira bien perrón, la neta.
The Eleanor Mustang, though, is a sick-ass car.
It's a beautiful car.
El Mustang ese que está en la foto específicamente se mira bien perrón. Pero los Mustangs en general a mí no me gustan.
Actually, this model of the Mustang won the most awards for the best looking car.
67 Fastback? Yep.
It's just beautiful. Like,
it's beautiful.
Look at that model, like that body. Mm.
One of the cars that sold the most out of the Challengers, the Camaros and all that stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And then 2010 came in, Camaro took off.
Camaro, leaving you know what, dude? Behind. Transformers did wonders for Chevy. Yeah. Like, it's ridiculous.
Es que esa película fue un comercial.
It was a long commercial.
Literalmente. Yeah. Yo estoy seguro que no anunciaron el carro para nada porque ya sabían que en la película iba.
Yeah.
No,
yeah.
And then they also released a Transformers edition.
Oh, on the, like of course they did.
On the steering wheel, it had the logo.
The Transformers.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Autobots logo.
Yeah.
Oh, el logo es oficial entonces.
Well,
o sea,
it was licensed.
Me refiero que me refiero que sale de la fábrica con el logo ya.
Yeah, that's
porque
what
yo yeah. pensé que porque he visto carros con él y pensé que algún loco nomás le...
Oh, I guarantee you those people for sure did.
Ah, okay.
But
yeah,
like
some people just buy the badge and they just put it on it, but the original one has Bumblebee on the seat, it has the logo on the seats, the steering wheel.
Okay.
And then on the side of the car.
See, in the new Camaros,
yeah.
They look like spaceships now. Like they no longer look like the old classics, but I think it's in a good way. Like it's they went modern, and I think I like that. But yeah, overall these are pretty sick cars. I remember watching Transformers and thinking, "Damn, Megan Fox." And then be like, "Dude, she likes Camaros? Maybe I should get a Camaro too, you know?" But
yeah,
that was just me. I named my drum set Megan Fox.
Búscame en el TikTok.
What a loser.
Excuse me, how many guitars do you have? They all have names.
Yeah, but
¿sabes cómo se llama ahora?
Fox. What the hell's wrong with you?
Megan. ¿Eh? That was her name, is Megan.
Megan se llama.
My drum set.
El drum set que está ahí en la sala, ¿sí cierto?
Yeah.
Ahora, ¿quién crees que la tienta todas las noches?
No, you don't. You're collecting dust over there.
No, pero llego y le pego una nalgada de volada.
One of esos días, I'm going to take her back. I'm gonna just
la
steal her.
La
no,
quiero,
no, no, I don't have room for her.
So Javi.
Oye, pero mientras tanto, búscame Kill, Smash, Mary on TikTok. Porque me dijiste que me acordara con la Megan Fox. Pero así, Kill, Mary, Smash, algo así.
Okay. ¿Cómo? FMK.
FMK se dice.
Yeah.
Javi.
Because it's
fun. Algo tenía que hablar contigo de carros, pero se me olvidó. A mí ni me interesan los carros, pero me acuerdo. Ah, ya me acordé. Mi carnal, el pollo. Hey, shout out to el pollo que puso en el Facebook. Hey, de perdida mano en un saludito. Dijo,
shout
no,
out.
Se me olvidó en el episodio pasado. Es mi carnal.
What up?
Mi hermano menor. Él sí estaba bien traumado en morro. Mm-hmm. Se compraba los Honda. Tú sabes que los morros que les gustan los carros. El Honda es el. Pero uno de los
Honda Civic was my first car.
Siempre se
va a poner. It's a good beginner car.
Yo creo que porque le puedes meter mano y las partes son relativamente baratas.
Cheap parts, they're cheap, reliable.
Reliable. Yeah, you can make it fast, but
las consigues de volada. Entonces, pues él armó su primer carro, fue un Acura Integra. Que por cierto están chilos esos carritos, ¿eh?
Acuras are really
y son bien, yeah. Son bien, ¿cómo se? Enviciados. No, ambiciados. O sea que
oh, yeah, they're sought
si,
after.
Si choca, si un Acura Integra está chocado y lo mandan al corral, de volada se venden las partes.
Ya. Yeah.
No, es difícil ir al corral y encontrar las partes que necesitas de volada. Tienes que estar esperando ahí como.
There's a lot of enthusiasts.
You gotta be camping for it. Integras. Ajá. Entonces, yeah. Por cierto, él me vendió mi primer Integra que nunca se lo pagué el pollo.
no le digas. Hey, Mickey, I'm sorry. You said FMK TikTok videos for Megan Fox?
No, Nell. O sea, este es un.
Just
it's
in general?
Like a game, yeah.
Okay.
Marry, kill, smash.
Okay, let's see. I'm just trying to do something right here. Give me a second.
I will let you do something.
By the way, mind you, I am doing the soundboard. Well, you explain this while I'm trying to do this.
Okay, el husky está. Es que el husky está haciendo soundboard. Sonido y cámaras ahorita.
Hey, shout out to Husky right now. Shout out to Husky one time, dude.
Es que,
because
okay.
My boy Husky's always putting it down.
El tocayo está castigado, ¿verdad? Dice que no, pero lo castigaron.
He's on house arrest.
Lo castigaron en su casa por no hacer la tarea de la escuela. Hey, mi carnal armó su primer Acura Integra. Era un carro, era automático y él lo hizo estándar. Y luego le quitó, le estaba bien traumado ese vato. Pollo, saludos para ti. Le quitó todos los asientos, nomás el del conductor. Le quitó la banda del aire. ¿Has escuchado que hacen eso algunos morros?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Le quitó el power steering, la banda del power steering.
Yep.
Supuestamente todo lo quita, le da más.
To reduce weight.
Sí, ándale del motor. Estrés y todo eso. Y,
okay, I'm just gonna start.
Sorry.
Okay. Y luego, este vato se iba a jugar carrera según él en la Speedway, no sé qué. En aquellos tiempos cuando estaba hace casi 400.
I bet that thing shook like crazy.
No, estaba bien stable el carro. Lo empachurró lo que pudo él. Yo creo que según él, por lo que yo escuché, no, porque yo no sé cómo funcionan las cosas, no, le cortó los resortes. Que, that's the shuntaro way of doing it.
No, yeah, you can cut your coilovers and get shorter.
O sea, yeah, cortó los resortes y estaba un poquito más bajito. Y el de este sí estaba duro, pero hacía su jale, pues, que si tú lo manejabas, porque when you're driving, no está duro el volante, nomás
así cuando está parado. Así es mi Beamer. El volante está duro.
Está duro, pero cuando le das, se ablanda, ¿no? Porque... así se entiende en Integra. Cuando están rotando en rotación las llantas, no está tan duro. Está más duro de lo regular.
It's harder to turn when it's not.
Si está parado, fast. No puedes.
Yeah. Dude, that's what my friend's Mustang, when she started the drive, like, it had no, what's it called? Steering, power steering. And that was a pain in the ass. But she would drive it like that. And it was so scary at times.
You get some arm, I mean, you know? My steering wheel
is a little bit hard, but it's not like to the point where you can't really turn it.
Yeah. I mean, it's still power steering, right? Or did you take off the power steering?
Oh, no, it still has it.
Yeah, there you go.
Y luego le pasó...
It's just for the sporty feel.
La bate. Yeah. Oh, en el motor, le abría el cofre. Que, por cierto, la batería estaba en la cajuela. ¿Por qué razón es eso?
Unos carros la tienen así. My Beamer has it in the back.
Pero él la puso ahí. El,
oh, like he wired it from there?
No sé, sí, o sea, como mandó los alambres para atrás. Ya no me acuerdo. Ya me acuerdo por qué. Porque le gustaba destapar el cofre y que se miraba el puro cuadro del motor ahí. Eso, eso era, así que...
Just to have a clean engine bay.
Le arrancó todos los alambres que eran inútiles, que son... Que no necesariamente se ocupan, pues.
Well, he already took out the AC and he took out the stereo. He took out a lot of stuff, so, I mean, it makes sense.
Sí, entonces...
I don't know.
Se miraba curada el cuadro del motor.
Dude, pero, that's nuts though. No AC en Nogales.
No, eso fue aquí en Tucson hace años cuando él vivía aquí.
Oh.
Se iba a la Speedway a jugar carreras.
No AC though en Tucson. That's
pues your... tenía ese carro nomás lo usaba para
yeah.
para eso en las noches.
No, I get it.
Estaba bien loco el pollo. Saludos, pollo.
Tenía otro carro. Like, did he have another car?
Sí.
Parte de la
Integra.
Sí, so it's literally just a race car then.
Nomás por... Era su juguete, literalmente.
That's cool,
le
man.
Metía mano y le hacía esto y lo otro.
Yeah, you see, that's gonna be a little bit hard for me.
¿Por qué? Because
whatever car I get, later on I just want to daily drive it.
Yeah.
Well, pues see, sí. For me, I always wanted the Ecto-1 and actually a DeLorean. And if I pimp it out to look like actually the actual props from the movie... I would want to drive it every single day of my life.
Exactly, because you want to
but,
show it
yeah,
off.
Yeah, yeah, I want to show it off. But at the same time, I don't want to drive it because, you know, I don't want it to get damaged or, you know,
people taking advantage of it. So this is what you do. Yeah. You get three dream cars. You alternate Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, you know, every day. So Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays is your Ecto-1.
Ooh.
Tuesdays and Thursdays are going to be your DeLorean. And then... what is
I'm
it?
Writing
Saturday
it down.
And Sunday, you.
I'm writing it down.
Whatever else you want to drive.
Actually, I need to add a writing down, like, little noise.
Oh, yes! Yeah. The writing in the notebook sound.
Yeah.
But imagine if I had the Ecto-1. How dope that would be.
That would be awesome. Dope. That would fit you so well.
Too. I know.
LG, but right, you want to know what's funny, though?
Oh,
I do.
You can't just have three project cars. You got to get a project for the daily. And then another one for that daily. And then a daily another, for that one.
A daily for the daily.
So you won't stop at three.
True. I mean, honestly, especially if you're into getting cars, I mean, you're not going to be satisfied.
Yeah.
You're always going to want the next thing. Like, in my mind, I'm like, I want a sick slammed van. I want an off-roader. And I also want like a streetable car.
Yeah.
So.
Husky. ¿Qué es lo que encontraste aquí? Porque esto se siente como que un poquito medio muy inapropiado para el gusto del gordo.
Yeah, I agree, but the reason why
the reason why
I chose this one because earlier we were talking about this certain word.
Ah, okay. Entonces ponlo.
So, ponlo. Let's see what happens.
Ponlo.
Apologies. Espérate, in advance.
Antes de que lo ponga, Javi, ¿te acuerdas que estábamos viendo esto en unos TikToks?
Yeah.
No, es lo que quería buscar para ponerle al gordo aquí.
All right, so let's see what happens.
Play it.
Listen. At heart, I'm a freaking boob guy. To me, there's nothing better than a set of juicy tatas. There's just few things in life I enjoy more than that. Yeah, yeah, yeah. In this scenario, you have to do it based on what you would want in the end. And this is the way I'm going to evaluate it. During sex, what do I need? I don't need a face. I guess I don't need a face. Fuck it. I think she's going to be headless, bro. I don't give a fuck. I'm killing the face. I'm going to take the tatas and I'm going to fuck the ass.
Oh, este no era lo que.
This is not at all. This is not at all what we were looking for.
First of all, let me.
You know what? No, screw this guy. Screw you and you sick man. Okay, women are not just objects.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Infinity War edition. You want to do this one?
Yes.
El que yo estaba buscando era literalmente puras fotos. La primera, la segunda y la tercera. Y eran tres morras y tú tenías que escoger.
Oh.
Yeah, you had to pick who you're gonna kill.
Who you would kill. Y son difíciles, ¿eh? O sea, una que otra está difícil.
Oh.
Pero.
Well, I don't know. I was just going by just what Google gave us and this is what came up. So I'm sorry.
So go. Just...
You want to do this one, though?
Yeah, click.
All right, let's do Avengers Infinity War.
Chris, sorry. And Chris, this is the eternal question of who is the best Chris.
Oh, I don't like this game because it has the F word in it.
Oh, we won't use that word, will we? We'll make love. Or just hang out with, because they're all men. And I'm married.
And I'm married.
No, Mary Kill. Those all wait, of those dudes are
good with
them? Chris is a great...
A ver, Gordo. Obviamente tenemos estos tres Chris's.
Uh-huh.
Kill...
Chris Evans, Chris Pratt, and Chris Hemsworth.
Kill, smash, and marry.
And okay.
Are you physical?
There's no right answer here because it's just gonna be sound bites for you.
Oh, but... ni siquiera estaba pensando en ese, pero qué bueno que me recordaste.
Nah, nice going.
Swear to God.
Don't swear
anyways,
to God.
Marry Chris Evans.
Okay.
Okay.
Gay, but go ahead.
F Chris Hemsworth and
what?
Kill Chris Pratt. I'm sorry. I love what? Chris Pratt. I do, but
oh my god.
And nomás
of the three
nomás,
Chris's of the three Chris's he is unfortunately.
Nomás en uno, estamos de acuerdo.
De acuerdo.
¿Cuál te imaginas?
F Chris Hemsworth?
Yeah.
I knew it. You're going to marry Chris Pratt.
Got him.
And I'll kill Chris Evans.
All right, it's up to you.
Let I mean play. I'll probably still smash, pero
but lo, dead body
but then I'll
or
kill
what?
But no, I'll smash before then I'll kill it.
Husky?
Espérate, el Javi primero Javi? Porque
oh,
no quiero
yeah, Javi.
No quiero influir en la de...
Damn.
It's not sus, bro, don't worry.
I think I would kill the middle one.
Chris Pratt,
Chris
my boy,
Pratt.
My
yeah.
husband.
Star Lord.
I'll kill. Yep.
Okay. Kill that.
How dare you? She's a nice lady.
Mary. I guess Thor.
Okay.
Mary Thor.
And then.
Estás bien morrito. Tú no te sabes los nombres.
Yeah, I don't know their names.
Lol.
I'll tell you. Okay. Ponme atención. Chris.
Mm-hmm.
Y luego Chris. Y luego Chris.
And also Chris. Yeah.
Got him.
So,
all three of them are Chris?
Yeah.
Chris Evans, Chris Hemsworth, Chris
what
Pratt.
You all get that?
Te lo dijo un poquito al revés, pero sí.
Yeah. Chris Evans on the top, Chris Pratt in the middle, Chris Hemsworth at the bottom.
Okay.
Evans, Pratt, Hemsworth.
Hemsworth.
Hemsworth. No lo puedo pronunciar bien. Okay, repite tus... De esto, ¿eh?
I forgot their name, sorry.
So, just say Captain America, Star-Lord,
and Thor.
Arriba.
Oh, okay. Then I'm going to have to switch a little bit then.
Okay.
Okay, so...
Smash.
The middle one definitely stays as a kill, though.
Okay, still kill Pratt.
Yeah.
Kill my husband, okay, cool.
Mary, the top one.
Okay.
And then F...
yeah, gay, son.
Hey, that's exactly my answer.
Tata.
Yeah.
Dijo tata, el gordo.
He said tata.
No, I said tata.
He said tata.
Dijo tata, ¿verdad?
Yep, that's it.
You said tata, gordo.
It is what it is.
I want to see if there's other...
Hug? I'll give a cake. What does that mean?
It's So give a hug to Chris Evans. Give a take give a on cake a to. Trip.
Kill Mary.
Oh shit.
Oh. Heck wow. Yeah. Heck yeah. Igualito que yo, mi compa.
I think people are tripping because Tom Holland answered it so fast when they asked him.
Y aparte contestó igualito que yo.
Everybody else was like,
oye,
I don't know.
No
and
sabía que
like, marry him, kill him.
No sabía que me caía también el Tom Holland.
Tom Holland? You didn't like him?
No,
you
o sea, no sabía before? Que no sabía que me caía también.
Yeah. He thinks a lot like you.
Amazing. I like it.
Yeah, wow. He thinks exactly like you actually. That's why I don't like following him.
Amazing.
On Twitter.
Oh, wait. Si lo sigues en Twitter y
I follow him on Instagram, yeah.
¿Y si tiene opiniones medio Mikis o qué?
No, I'm just...
¿A media Mikis?
Ya me iba a casar con él.
Half Mickey. Half Mickey is the term.
Okay.
Give me a... We don't have queries, but...
Hubiéramos preguntado.
We have Javi here.
No, pues tenemos al Javi. ¿Qué ibas a decir? Oye, no, yo... Okay.
Get to the thing that I know you want to get to.
Sí, pero también... entonces ya no le vamos a entrar con esto de las morras, ¿no? Porque... Bueno,
no.
Ok, Javi, ¿cuáles eran las morras? ¿Cuáles eran las morras? ¿Te acuerdas?
Uf.
Era, déjame acordarme, me falta una nomás, pero era la de Transformer. ¿Cómo dijiste ahorita? ¿La
Megan Fox?
Megan Fox.
Megan Fox.
Scarlett Johansson. ¿Y okay. cuál es la tercera? Porque estaba difícil para algunas personas esta.
Wasn't it
A ver, búscala a ver si te la pone Kill Mary.
I don't know if this was on the same video, ¿quién era? But was it Sniper Wolf?
Or oh, that, no, estos eran no. YouTubers literalmente.
Okay.
Era Sniper Wolf, la... ¿Cómo se llama? Tana Mango, algo así se llama.
Tana Mango. Mango.
Tana Mango y Janet García eran. Esas eran las tres, creo.
Yeah.
¿Es Janet García Logic's ex-wife?
No sé.
I don't know.
You know what I'm talking
about?
No. I don't know.
Ponme las tres fotos, ahí están.
But these are right, I thought you said there was Scarlett Johansson involved and stuff.
Es que había uno donde estaba la Scarlett Johansson y la Megan Fox y había una tercera y no me puedo acordar.
The thing is that I don't know these YouTubers slash. Oh, that's the Janet Garcia from the
sí, pues.
Mary, instant Mary.
Wait, who's this?
Yeah.
Dude, what do you mean who is this?
Es la que da el weather en los noticieros en español.
Oh, wow.
She single-handedly has made countless boys into men watching the news.
Nomás con ver el clima, ya te haces
just
hombre.
To find out what the weather... You want to know what the weather's like?
I'll
tell you what. Chance of showers.
The weather's
I kind of don't want to even show these pictures. They're so bad.
The weather's hot.
I kind of want to keep these pictures for us.
Yeah. Don't show that.
No, oye. No. Pero, verás,
Jesus
coming in hot.
Ponle coma.
Just like a fajita.
Ponle Sniper Wolf. Ahí a un ladito el nombre de Janet García. Sniper Wolf. ¿Y cuál era la otra? Dijimos Tana Mango. No, el apellido se escribe
Sniper bien raro. Wolf?
Sí, Sniper Wolf.
Okay. I'm already enjoying the view here. Okay, Sniper Wolf, ¿y qué?
Y luego Tana.
How you spell that? T-A-N-N-A?
Y sí, pero el apellido no sé cómo.
M-O-N-G-E.
Ok, no aparecen todas, pero ahí están las dos abajo, en la segunda foto.
¿De eso?
Sí, es la misma, pero pícale. Esa... Está,
¡sick!
¡Sick!
Ni modo. ¿Tú
like
sabes quién es Sniper Wolf?
I don't know none of these.
No.
Wait, Janet really? García sí la conoces.
I do know her, but she's a weather girl.
Es la que ¿cómo se llama el comediante ese que te enseñé
not
la otra
just
vez?
A weather girl, the
el,
weather
the
girl.
Review, gordo, ¿cómo se llama es australiano?
Oh, Aussie man.
Aussie man, él habló de ella en el
can I just say
please,
we're not showing these.
We're down bad right now, bro.
Yeah. Can I just say thank you for letting me know about this person? I did not know this person existed.
Janet García es la morra
it's
más bonita de México.
Dude, wow. easily.
Anyways, let's move on because I feel like we're doing something.
Instant wedding ring. I put myself in debt for her, bro.
Yeah, moving on.
Okay, Javi. Mando. Bueno, el Javi, ¿todavía estás trabajando donde me dijiste que estás trabajando?
Yep.
Les, no sé si sabían, pero el Javi trabaja cuidando muertos.
Bro, before this podcast, nadie sabía quién era. We were like, oh, I don't know if you knew this about a little fun little fact about
no sé
our
si
boy,
tú sabías, gordo, pero el Javi trabaja cuidando muertos.
Oh, yeah, I did find
¿así that. Sabía, entonces?
Well, kind of. Right?
Oye,
yeah, I'm an assistant.
He's an assistant.
¿Cuánto tiempo llevas ahí?
About a month, going for two.
So what do you do exactly?
Okay, let's start there. So, at first, what I do is I assist the family when there's a service. You know, like, okay. Just help set up the room.
Oh, tienes que trabajar en el velorio.
Yeah. I bring the loved one out. I open the casket. Sometimes the family wants to put items in there, and they're like, "Can you do it?" Low. Most of the time, I'm like, "Hell no!" But I mean, you just like, if there's no one around, then that's when I start sweating.
Pero te ha tocado trabajar tentando los muertos literalmente con tus manos.
Que los tengo que tocar.
O sea,
like to move it,
moverlo, acomodarlo, yeah. Como darle los brazos y
con
todo
guantes.
Eso.
Yeah. Hay veces que nomás está ahí acostado and we have to like fix their hands. Y les tenemos que poner algo aquí abajo para que se queden así en place.
Husky, verás.
Wow.
Verás, yeah. Un paréntesis de bola. Abre otra ventana, yeah, para que no se quite it. La música. Y a ver si te puede abrir el link que puse. No, nomás hazlo mute.
Oh, okay.
A yeah. Ver, nomás para ver si le pusieron timestamps a las preguntas.
So, Javi.
Mande.
I gotta ask. Do they put COVID masks on the dead bodies?
No.
Just check it. Wouldn't it be weird if you see the mask and you see... Like, you could see them breathing through the mask?
Bro, I would be getting the fuck out of there.
Yeah. Get an exorcist, because that body's possessed. Dude, okay. So, working at a morgue. Morgue, right? That's what it's called?
¿En cuál estás trabajando?
Cemetery, mortuary.
¿En cuál estás trabajando?
Funeral home.
¿Puedes decir o no?
No, let's not say where. Let's not get into specifics.
Hey, no necesito que me expliquen ustedes. Le estoy preguntando a él, mis compas. Él puede decir, no, prefiero no decirlo ya.
You're right.
Don't say it.
Freaking but also
black,
don't say it.
Freaking Black Knights.
Yeah, but don't say it.
Yeah, I'm not allowed to.
It's fine. What I did want to know is, do you guys handle cremations?
We do.
Sick.
Te toca ver qué avienta en el cuerpo. Tengo una pregunta. No sé si tú me la puedes contestar. Pero dime lo que traes.
Okay. when it comes to a cremation.
Yeah.
From the service that I've done, it's like I go, I pick up the loved one, I drop it off at the family's house, and they have it there for at least a night, and then I have to go pick it up the next day, take it to the care center, and that's when they take care of the cremation and everything.
Cuando dices que they have it there for at least a night, ¿en qué está él?
Oh, he's in the casket already.
The broth.
En lo que lo enterrarían si no lo fueran a quemar. Entonces, ¿y está abierto? O sea...
Dependiendo...
¿Hay vidrio?
Con la familia, pues.
Now, going to that question that you just said, you take the body to the family's house?
Yeah.
Is this a requirement that you have to take it, or they're like, no, we don't want this body in there?
It depends on the family, yeah. Really.
Well,
from all the service that I've done, I have to go drop it off to the family, and then the next day, that's when I go pick it up.
Yeah.
It's like,
no, I do the first half that's one just day, kind of
and
creepy?
Then the second day, I just do the yeah. second half of that.
¿Sabes qué, Mickey? I was just thinking about this, and I've been wanting to tell you this. Sorry that I'm jumping out of this. There's actually a scary movie in regards to that. Apparently, I think that's a Jewish trait, right? That when somebody passes away, they keep the body in the house for 24 hours, and people have to stay vigilant on that body because there's like, supposedly they say that there's like evil spirits.
Oh, trying to get in?
Yeah. And they need to stay on like 24 around the body.
The vigil for...
But there's a scary movie that just came out in regards to that. And it looks so good, and I kind of want Mickey... I kind of want to watch it too, but wait. I'm going to freak that out.
¿Y dónde está? ¿Dónde está la película? Porque la voy a ver esta noche.
I don't know. I'll find it. I have to find it. But I remember I saved it just so I could show it to you. But that kind of reminds me of that, of what you were just talking about. That's kind of creepy. Yeah.
Pero, okay. Bueno. Entonces, esa es... ¿Cómo se le dice? Esa discreción de la familia, ¿cómo lo pones? ¿No? Si ellos lo quieren tapado o si no... Quiere decir que si lo llevas destapado, la familia lo puede tentar, ¿no?
When I'm taking the body over,
sí, cuando,
it's in the casket and it's closed.
Uh-huh.
And when the family gets it, they have the option to either open
hours.
It, to open it, and they can do whatever they want.
Just to confirm that the body is there and that that's the person. Because I feel like that's the reason why they do that, right? To get closure.
Okay, so for that one, I take care of that. It's like, before I go pick it up and take it to the family, it's like I have to check their tag, making sure it's the right person.
Oh my god. Remember, like, in the beginning of this whole pandemic, that people were getting the wrong bodies, you know? Like, this is not, this is not, like,
there was such a high demand,
yeah,
that they had, like, mix-ups.
Mix-ups. It's like, this is not my beloved, you know, like.
They're like, who he?
Yeah, I don't know this person.
I don't know him.
And they had to go and swap up the bodies. Like, man.
Like, I get it. They both dead, but he not.
Yeah.
That's not it. This ain't it.
Okay.
Do you get a refund at that point?
I know. Like, do you get a discount or something? I don't know.
Free flowers.
Now,
free,
if I was bouquet. The person dropping it off and it was the wrong person, I don't know. What would I do?
You would feel horrible.
You double back.
I
mean,
yeah, I would feel horrible, but at the same time, it's like,
Can we pretend, vas a decir?
No quiero, no vamos a ver el video, pero para los que nos están escuchando, acaba de salir este video. Ask, ¿cómo se llama el?
It's called.
¿Cómo se llama ese channel? Tiene un nombre bien conocido.
Wired.
Tech Support. No, pero específicamente esta serie es Tech Support y este es un mortician. Salió hace como 2 semanas, ¿no? Sí, hace casi 2 semanas y media. Yeah. Este vato contesta muchas preguntas y está curada para que lo, si lo quieren ver en Mortician Answers Dead Body Questions from Twitter. Explica que, por ejemplo, if you're an organ donor, mm-hmm, que otra compañía viene y hace harvest los de estos y luego ya le dan el cuerpo a él y él se encarga de inyectarle, sacarle toda la sangre al cuerpo y meterle una sangre.
Yeah, le meten un chemical.
Sí.
So that way the body doesn't decay too fast.
Y para devolverle un poquito el color, uh-huh, a la piel, sí, aparentemente no.
Oh,
¿a ti te ha tocado saber?
Yo no hago ese trabajo, pero sí.
Sí, has escuchado ahí alrededor de ti. Pero los órganos, ¿quién los saca en tu de este?
Entonces, it's a different position right there. Tú eres un, like, you just stay on that spot right there. Mm. Like, you get the body, you open it, get everything out. You también all the blood out, and then yeah, at the end you put in the chemical and then you have to like stitch it just so that way it doesn't leak.
I kind of want to hear what he says about this because this might concern me.
So let's play. Regresate a donde
go back just a little bit.
No, he's reading right now the question.
Apenas lo está leyendo.
Yeah, here we go.
Okay, full disclosure, I'm fat and this is a legit question. I'm not trying to be fat phobic, but how do extremely obese people, like I'm talking 400 plus pounds, fit in a coffin? Do they make a plus-size coffin? Or does a mortician, like, cut fat out of them and sew them back up? I'm gonna answer the second part of that question first. No, we do not remove fat and sew someone back up. Everybody is buried intact, if we can at all help it. So we actually have caskets that are made by our manufacturer to be oversized. Typically, when someone passes away, if they're larger, we'll measure them at their elbows, because those tend to be the parts that stick out the furthest, mm-hmm, and then determine what width of casket we will need to give them a more comfortable appearance. See for Chase.
Pero ponemos, okay. Mortician. Oye, aparte, wow, que está interesante lo que dijo, la mirada de este vato me hace sentir como que está ido él ya.
Also, his eyebrows are jumpy, so it makes me uneasy.
Como que él está viendo cosas que nosotros no podemos ver, se me figura. Así vas a andar tú, Javi, el rato.
Why is it that people that also work on this kind of stuff, morticians, they look dead too?
I was gonna say. Yeah. Oh,
I guess it's just. I mean, I'm hoping.
Yeah.
I don't end up like that. But it's like you get used to seeing,
yeah,
a dead body, and then, yeah, it's like, he's dead, you know? Like,
it's just another, yeah, it's just work.
It's like, you basically just, you just lost right there part of your humanity right there.
Yeah.
But it makes you more effective that way at your job.
Does it make you have more of a dark humor on certain things? I mean, we were just talking about like the whole, what's his name? Logan Paul?
Oh, see, Logan Paul.
So, yeah, because it's like, you get used to it.
Yeah.
You don't feel weird or bothered, yeah, by it anymore. That it's just the point where, like, I could joke around with this and, yeah, I won't get, so, like, butt hurt.
I really want to see, yeah, I really want to see that extra wide coffin, like those plus size coffins.
Can I just say something that I already said before, that I'm claustrophobic, so I'm just putting it out there. And for this episode, if I were to die and if you have my body, please cremate me. But before you do this, stab my freaking brain just to make sure I am completely dead. Just to make sure.
Javi. Porque se me había olvidado hace rato.
Hey, I gotta make sure.
Quiero saber algo. ¿Te ha tocado ver cuando están quemando el cuerpo? ¿Cómo se dice en español? ¿Por qué no se dice cremando?
Cremación.
¿Cremación? Sí se dice cremando, entonces. Bueno, no importa. Cuando están quemando el cuerpo, ¿te ha tocado ver ahí que lo meten o eso, en esa área no te metes tú?
En esa área no me meto yo.
Ok, de todos modos, mi pregunta es esta. Los vatos que queman el cuerpo y sacan las cenizas y las avienten en un... ¿Cómo le llaman esa cosa? En un urn. ¿Se aseguran de sacar todas las cenizas y limpian antes de poner otro cuerpo o andan quemando cuerpos con cuerpos?
No. Entonces, ¿sé lo que me estás diciendo?
Sí.
Y la respuesta en eso es que cuando meten el cuerpo, lo queman y una vez que ya están listas las cenizas, con un brush, agarran todo lo que puedan agarrar y lo echan en una bag.
Ok.
Y en esa bag ponen un disco. Ese disco es como una moneda. Pero se la ponen al cuerpo para que se queme junto con la moneda. Y luego agarran la moneda y la ponen con la bag. So that we know, like...
¿Quién era?
¿Quién es?
Ah.
Y tiene su number también.
Ok.
Like, every dead person has, like, their own number.
That's crazy. O sea, que meten el cuerpo y le ponen el disco en la parte del cuerpo antes de quemarlo.
Ajá. Es, like, el disco se lo... Bueno, no se lo ponemos así encima del cuerpo.
Como un medallón, ¿verdad?
Ajá. Y ya nomás... una vez que ya agarramos todo lo que se puede agarrar, se limpia como si fuera... Es como si lo estuvieras haciendo vacuum, pues todas las cenizas se van a ir juntas.
Okay.
I have a question that I don't know if you have an answer to, but do you happen to know to what temperature, to what degree that fire has to be for the body to burn fully?
I do not.
I'm just curious how hot the fire has to be. Like, I mean, it's fire, but...
¿Has visto la máquina?
Es,
el horno, pues.
Es como, you know how in hospitals they have, like, their places to, like, just, like,
put the body in there?
Las cajones esos.
Yeah. It's basically like that.
Mm.
But instead of freezing the body, it just lights up.
Pretty nuts. Do you,
Voy a tener que ver un video.
Okay. This might sound really insensitive.
Here we go.
Espérate, Husky, busca true, así como le hiciste ahorita que te topaste. No. Mm-hmm. En el video que ya estabas.
Oh, just keep on playing it?
No. Pues, como puedes leer sin tener que ver el video, si te interesa otra pregunta.
Well, that's right. I'll keep on playing it.
Okay.
Okay, cool. Sorry.
So, do you think that... My question was... do bones really burn the way they do? Because I always imagine them, they have to, like, crunch them after they get burned a certain amount to really get them to pulverize.
So for that one, I think they do. I'm not 100% sure. It's just like
I know it's a weird question.
Since
but...
it's already burned.
Yeah.
Pues nomás como que le pega un poquito para que se deshaga bien.
Right.
Just so that way everything fits in the bag.
Because, I mean, it has to be, like, a fine ash, right? I mean...
Qué loco que un cuerpo completo, ¿a poco se reduce a todo eso?
Yeah.
Qué loco, ¿no?
Because we're, like, 60% water. Or 70% water, anyways.
Also, like, the teeth, like, I heard
then,
that it pops like popcorn.
The... Like, blood y todo eso.
Ajá.
Sometimes when it's a cremation, todavía le hacen eso, like...
Sacarle la sangre.
Le sacan the guts. Out. Yeah. And they add like the chemical so that way it doesn't decompose too fast.
Mm-hmm.
Because I've had some caskets where the family was like, oh, we don't want them to do that to this one. And later on, it smells like you can tell.
Yeah.
And it's not a pleasant smell.
Oh, no. The smell of literally a rotting corpse.
Yep.
Ugh.
Oh, él pregunta esto. Una de las cosas que él mencionó en una de las preguntas que le hicieron se trataba de que si cómo se siente él about knowing that que uno de sus familiares y seres queridos también se van a morir, porque él dice que a este punto de su vida ver un cuerpo muerto es como ver trabajo para cualquier otra persona. Por ejemplo, para él ver un cuerpo muerto es como para mí llegar a una casa y ver un sink desarmado ahí.
Yeah.
Oh, it's work for me.
Or a butcher just looking at.
Yeah.
A mí, ándale,
big
pues,
slab
una,
of cow.
Una vaca. Oh. Pues él llega y dice que es una de las cosas que le preocupaban al principio de imaginarse a él mismo ver el cuerpo muerto de un familiar de él y en vez de sentir dolor, sentir verlo como un trabajo más.
Yeah.
Okay, so for that one, I can actually answer.
A ver.
And, oh, yo mismo, I don't feel like that. Like, if I just picture it, like, just imagine it. Because before I started working here, I never thought about death at all.
Okay.
And now that I'm working there, it's like, I think about it more. And yeah. I started to, like, appreciate more, like, my family, you know, my friends yeah. and stuff. Because when I picture somebody that I know, then, yeah, you get, like, really emotional. I get emotional.
Yeah.
And I'm just scared that I might lose that because of this job.
¿Tienes miedo que lo vas a perder? Porque sí. es lo que él decía también, que al principio se preocupaba que... Pero dice que no llegó a ese punto, pero...
Es lo único que me preocupaba, pero the more I keep working yeah. right there, I still feel the same way.
The more you realize that you are human, you still have a heart.
Oye, yeah. Por ejemplo, tengo varias preguntas. Número uno, las voy a decir todas para que no se me olvide. Número uno, ¿cómo fue que llegaste a este jale?
What's with this one?
Y obviamente tienes poquito tiempo ahorita. Mm-hmm. Ahí, ¿cuántos cuerpos dirías que has visto hasta ahorita?
Pues... pues llegué ahí nomás porque... I really needed a job, so I was like, I'll get whatever I can get.
Yeah. ¿Pero conoces a alguien ahí, Hugo? Porque eso no es un jale que te topas de repente, pues, que no.
No, de hecho, es un trabajo que cualquiera puede agarrar. It's like really easy to get in. You don't really need like any special requirements or anything.
Everybody dies, Mickey.
Ahorita
not everybody works in death.
Unless you want to do like the... Cuando abres el cuerpo and you get like all the organs out, then right there you do need to like have like...
Dissect.
Like a certification saying like, hey, he knows how to do this. Pero for like the type of job I do...
¿Qué es lo que dijiste que eres? ¿Asistente or intern?
Yo soy asistente.
Okay.
So my job is just assisting families, assisting funerals, transporting.
¿Cómo te levantaste un día y dijiste voy a buscar trabajo?
Pues yo siempre miraba, like I would get to see how people would go to the scenes and pick up the dead person and then
like
take
in crime
them to
scenes?
Like yeah.
Okay.
And I honestly found that really interesting, and I still want to do that job specifically because mm-hmm. the one that I do is like when I see the dead body is already like well dressed, you don't see like
okay
like if they got stabbed or anything. It's yeah. like you just see them laying down.
Yeah, the clean.
What I really want to do is I want to go to the scene, get the body in the bag, transport it to like somewhere.
So
the
coroner.
So that's what I like crime scene, like CSI. What I would. I have a friend who worked at the police department, and he Guinness. Worked. His name will be confidential, but he worked at the police station for the crime lab. He would actually take pictures of the scene and stuff. He actually quit. Him and like three other people quit after like one really really messed up crime scene.
Oh,
he still hasn't talked. He still hasn't told me what it was, how it looked, or what it was like. He had like to describe it, but he said, "Man, he's like after that, I couldn't do it."
Yeah.
So like, it's scarring. Like this, like it, especially when you realize that it's not a movie. Like yeah. this is like real. Like, and people are evil, dude. Like
yeah. Like I have that in mind already. It's like I know I'm gonna like if I
you might get scarred for life.
If I do end up getting that job, I know. I'm going to have that image in forever.
Yep.
Like, I'm not going to forget.
You're going to actually need, what's it called? What's it called?
I know
psychology,
some people,
like, you know, like...
Yeah, yeah, you will need therapy.
Therapy,
like,
there
I
go.
Know
yeah.
some people, they, like, they can do it like nothing, you know?
Sure.
But there's always going to be people that don't feel comfortable seeing, like, guts, blood... Yeah.
Oh, mira, el husky. You got to turn off that part of your brain.
El husky encontró la pregunta que estaba diciendo ahorita. ¿La quieres ver o...? ¿Quieren ver qué contestó él o qué onda? Gordo.
Sure, why not?
Ahora pues.
All right, let me just do this.
Amazing.
And let's see, let's play it.
Leonard de Montague. Does a mortician feel just as sad as a normal person when someone close to them dies? The short answer of that is yes. That was one of the things, actually, I myself really worried about when I got into this profession. Because at a certain point, when you see a dead body, you almost always kind of go into work mode. What can I do to help this family? What can I do to prepare this body? So I was very concerned when I started doing this that maybe I would start to even think of my own loved ones as something to help or something to fix, and not really take in grief like I used to. For my own family, for loved ones, my own grandpa passed away just a few months ago, and I feel just as sad about that as I think I ever would. It's just a matter of perspective and maybe where you're at the moment.
Interesting.
Question. Nice.
Okay. Interesting.
Also, this guy, like what he's saying is right, but I don't know. Like, I feel like he's weird. Like, he's odd, man. Like, he
es que definitivamente ya perdió algo, ¿verdad?
Un poquito de humanidad. He feels more like a programmed bot than a human at
como
this point.
Que yeah. He lost some of his humanity already.
Maybe, man.
Oh, de perdida nosotros porque él está en otro nivel de...
Well, then again, we've never met him before, you know? Yeah.
¿Cuál es la palabra que se usa para referirse a que te gusta ver cosas? Why are we so...
intrigued?
Pues sí, es... es algo que describe a alguien que está intrigued en eso. Pero bueno, también.
Obsessed.
Sí, todo eso está encerrado en la misma palabra, pero... more something.
Yeah. Whoa, what was that? Frick?
Oh, yeah, fue el gol.
Oh. Actually, I wanted to know that for you, Javi, that now that you've been working at this place, right? Mm-hmm. You know how people always say, like, make time to... invest in your like your funeral and stuff, you know, like be prepared and you know, is that actually something that you are thinking or actually are already planning?
Not
you
really.
Know what you, estás planeando morirte,
are you
no?
planning on
no,
dying
no,
soon?
You know, you know like how you make your wills and all that stuff. Be working there, has it made you make your last will and testament and all that stuff and actually make sure that nobody else has to worry about financially paying for your funeral costs, you
okay,
know?
Okay, so for, like, urns and caskets like that?
Well, yeah.
I had thought about it, but it's, like, when you think about it, it's not that, I mean, I'm ready to die or anything.
Yeah, yeah.
But it's just, like,
it just makes
happen,
you, like,
you know?
Prepare, you know?
Well,
and that's what I'm trying to say.
I think that's something I do want to do.
Yeah.
Because, let's say something does end up happening, right?
Yeah.
I don't want my family to like
to worry
have,
about the
have
costs
to worry
and stuff.
About paying the spot, paying
yeah.
for cremation, urns and stuff like that.
Yeah.
I have a question. Why is it so gosh darn expensive to die?
That's a really good question.
Like you
actually,
know, like
everyone
dies, right?
Well, you see, the caskets are actually made out of tough material. So
yeah.
just in case of a natural disaster, it doesn't, like,
but
break or
why?
Anything.
Their bodies decompose in the shells. Like, I always thought about this. I'm like, wouldn't it be easier to just make it out of composite wood and
if
just...
If you're the one paying for it,
yeah,
it's like when you die, you're not going to take any of that money with you.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I mean,
might as well just put some use into it.
Well, you
like,
put that down
gonna,
for other...
If you're going to, like, get... cremated or something like that, at least have a nice one, you know?
Yeah, but like to me it's like this is all part of the more tradition ritualistic or like it's for the family, right? Like that's how I see it. So it's like for me personally, I've always said this, I'm like I don't care for a fancy, you know, cherry wood, you know, casket that's like lined with gold or brass or whatever, you know, like they always have like this fancy, super fancy casket, and I'm like I don't care about any of that. Like honestly, you can wrap me in a newspaper and throw me in a hole because I'm gonna die and it doesn't matter because I'm dead,
you know what, you know? Gordo, if you die before Mickey, Hey Plebes is gonna sponsor your funeral. It's gonna have the logo on the coffin
yeah.
and everything.
Los caskets son no son waterproof ni nada.
Oh, he said they're made of like
pura madera. O sea que se meten los gusanos a comerte, ¿sí o no?
No son de madera.
¿De qué son
de es como metal, but it's like really tough.
Pero no son sellados, ¿no?
Some of them are, some of them it just depends on what type of locking system you have on it.
Por ejemplo, ¿tú crees que no se meten gusanos de afuera para adentro a comerte?
Do they have emergency exit doors from the inside?
No.
Okay, just check.
Don't say that. Don't say that. You know I'm claustrophobic and now I'm thinking about it. Let's not. Actually, I found the video. Do you want me to play this? He talks about why coffins are expensive.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. Play it.
Cool.
Let me just mute this.
Even have to mute it.
Una de las cosas,
no, because the mientras, music plays.
Mientras lo haces, es que una de las cosas que dijo este vato que se me hizo curada como paréntesis, es que dice que a estos vatos en las, como estudian para esto, ¿no? Obviamente, uh-huh. les dan clases y todo y toman su bachelor, como se le llame. Una de las clases es para aprender a maquillar también ellos.
Oh, yeah. So they actually look like they're alive.
Ándale.
A mí me ha tocado ver cuando los maquillan. También.
¿Sí? Oh, sí te ha tocado ver eso. Mm-hmm. O sea, nada especial, ¿no? Pero de perdida para devolverle el color
a
la piel.
I think it's really cool, though, because they do such a really good job to the point, like, it could be a suicide, could be a murder. Like, instead of, let's say they get shot on the head, right?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
They do such a good job, you can't even tell.
Where they got...
Yeah, like, you can't even tell where they got shot, or if they even got shot, you know?
Yeah.
O sea, lo hacen verse como si estuviera dormido el muerto.
Yeah, which is why I think it's, like, you really, know, honestly, really cool.
I think doing that, doing the makeup, is more... Less of a... I would feel more human doing that. I think... I still feel that it's not a dead person, a body that I'm working on. It's just somebody's makeup I'm doing.
A mannequin,
you know?
Or something.
Yeah, a mannequin. And I think it's still like that barrier, you know?
Yeah.
Where I'm like, mean, oh my, I'm working on a dead body, you know?
It's still a corpse.
Yeah. So. All right, let's see what this guy says about why are coffins so expensive.
Morbidly es la palabra que estaba buscando nomás.
Morbidly?
What? Morbidly.
Oh, morbidly.
Yeah.
Okay.
Morbidly es la palabra que
yeah, yeah, that's obsessed. When you're like stupidly obsessed.
Yeah.
Gotcha. Here we go.
From Soggy Emma. Why are coffins so expensive, y'all? Just bury me raw.
Well,
Soggy Emma, that is like that. Definitely an option. You can be buried in the ground without a casket.
What?
A lot of funeral homes put substantial markups on their casket. And I think it's just a way to collect money on the tail end of a service, but just like a furniture store, which would maybe mark up their kitchen tables four times what they actually cost, I would guess that most caskets are marked up probably 1.5 to 2 times what the wholesale cost is. This is a question from...
That's actually pretty interesting. Yeah. I didn't even know about that.
Que si te podían enterrar raw?
And now they
probably just wrap you in.
I think it makes sense because the only thing they ask for when we like just bury someone is just a permit.
Oh.
Because there's like this permit that we have to like have for the state.
Para verificar que sí pagaron el permiso y todo eso nomás.
It's just we get permission from the state to.
Oye, el terreno donde entierras a alguien se compra, ¿no?
Yeah.
No se renta. que estaría raro eso.
I've heard que se puede rentar, pero hay veces nomás lo hacen pues nada más por el service and then they transport it to somewhere else.
They move the bodies to a different location.
Oh, como que lo entierran, pero no lo entierran.
For the ceremonial part of it.
O sea, lo bajan al hoyo y todo.
Así como que estás rentando este lugar por cierto tiempo y luego digamos, for example, there's a service going on here in Tucson, but they actually want to do the burial in Texas or Phoenix, you know?
Entonces, ¿lo bajan a un hoyo para ceremonia o no?
Nomás lo bajan, lo tapan, pero no lo...
They don't bury it in dirt. Yeah. They just like...
Interesting.
What are they... Gordo, is that like when they throw the flowers on it and they...
En cuanto escuché que te podemos tirar así, raw, entonces si vamos a ser sponsor to this.
Heck yeah. wrap me in Hey Plebes tape.
I know. I did hear... Oh, we have the tape. One thing that I did hear about is that also people are now saying that you could actually put them in like in this, the body like in this sack kind of thing, that your body becomes one with the earth and it grows a tree.
Oh yeah, they cremate your body and they mix your ashes with a potted plant.
Is that something that's already provided, like that you could offer an option?
I'm pretty sure you can ask for it. I'm not 100% sure on that one. I don't know if the funeral home does it or if you have to go to like another place for that.
That's such a weird thing.
My body becomes a tree, right? But then everybody, like dogs and even people that are drunk, are pissing on me.
It's like I said, like as long as you have the permit for that stuff, you should be good. Because I know there's people that say like, oh, I want you guys to like just dump my ashes on the ocean.
Yeah.
You know?
And also, yeah, they do weird things. Like, they'll go to the top of a mountain and throw the ashes, or they go to the ocean. We even know about a story of people trying to sneak ashes into Disneyland.
Yeah, at the Haunted Mansion.
Throw it into the waters of Pirates of the Caribbean.
Haunted Mansion and stuff, yeah.
Checa la pregunta que le hicieron en
yeah, I want to play this one next. Let's play it.
Tiny rain Do morticians put a bra on you? If so, I would like my rotting corpse to not wear a bra, and would like my ghost to be wandering braless with poking nips. Well, okay. Tiny Rain, I don't know if there's much I can do about poking nips, but we do put bras on if the family requests. And the reality is, I've probably put on more bras than I have taken off in my life. To answer your question.
That's a good one. That's
bro.
¿No te ha tocado poner brasier a ti? ¿Te ha tocado vestir a la gente?
No.
¿A los muertos?
No, he's not in that.
No, you're not in that part. Puro transportar.
Bueno, a menos de que la familia lleve algo and they're like, hey, can you put this on?
¿Te gusta?
Then I'm like, I'd rather not.
Okay, yeah. ya te entendí. Pero, oye, ¿te gusta el jale? ¿Te gusta el jale para quedarte un buen tiempo ahí? ¿O nomás lo estás haciendo mientras sigues estudiando y ganando?
Al principio nomás lo hice por el trabajo. Ajá. Pero now that I'm actually doing it and understanding, like, because right now I'm learning religions I didn't even know about. I'm learning so many things that I didn't even know.
Yeah.
And that's what I like about it.
En unos 6 meses deberías de venir otra vez y contarnos everything that
you
learned.
So far, how many religions have you had to learn? You know,
because Jewish, I didn't really know much about Jewish.
Mm-hmm. Oh, and there's a lot of rules there.
And so I had one of the services, and then they were like, "Oh, since it's tradition, we have to do this, we have to do that." And at first, I was like, "That's crazy! I didn't even know that. I thought it was just gonna be like a regular service, you know?"
Yeah.
And it's weird because at first I'm like, what's a regular service for you? You know? It's like, for me, true. A regular service is just like, va el padre, dice lo que tiene que decir, you lower it.
Yeah.
That's a regular service for me.
Shoot, for me, it's a 3-day service.
For us, it's, well, it depends. Because I've done a 24-hour vigil for my grandpa.
Mm-hmm.
But for the most part, it's like a service. Yeah. A service. And then they bury the body with some words, and that's it.
And see, that's the thing. I grew up going to these, like, church funerals where the first day is about, like, a whole preaching service, you know, and having the body there. The next day, same thing, you know, just reminding, you know, life is short, you know, repent.
Repent! Yeah, they always try to get you like that.
That same day, either we bury the body or we go to the third day, where we go to the actual, like, the church to do the last things, then drive to the funeral, to the burial site, and then bury the body.
Well, yeah, there's the burial, and then there's the funeral service.
And then there's the after party.
Oye, gordo, ya quiero estar muerto para que en mi velorio estar tirado ahí, luego levantarme, arreglar el sonido, porque le van a cagar, andan cagando el palo,
Yeah, no, you're like,
the frick, ¿quién está en la consola ya?
No, Mickey's like, no mames.
You better play Meant to Live by Switchfoot right now.
It's gonna be all quiet on the moment of silence.
Oh man, dude, I already said it that my funeral's gonna be popping, dude. I'm gonna have like a giant moon bounce, like the brincabrincas, you know. It's gonna be like a carne asada going on. Like, we're not gonna, all the money that we saved from the freaking casket is gonna be given to the food.
Gordo, con una nalga que te arranquemos, comemos todos.
I mean, okay, yeah. Because I'm going to be doing a lot of squats right, before that day.
The thing is that I don't want a 3-day service. I think it's just pointless.
Two-week dream.
Just do a one service where everybody roasts me. Talk all the crap
the
you
roast
want.
Of Husky?
Yeah, on the 5th. And then I'll decide if I want to haunt you guys, you know?
Yeah, he was a real piece of shit.
Yeah. You know what? Husky was such an asshole.
But God damn it, do I love him.
But he was my asshole.
Yeah, he loved Disney. I'll tell you what.
You know, he was a little Disney jerk.
I love that in this scenario, we're all like chain smokers.
Husky was such an asshole.
Oh, God, I loved him.
God, I loved him.
We went to Disneyland so many times.
Va a estar predicando el hermano Cuco en mi velorio acá. Y un habladero. ¡Ey! ¡Ya córtale, hermano! ¡Ya quiero que me entierren!
Dude, what's hilarious is thinking that we're going to die well before the old people that we know.
Well, oye, entonces, ¿qué va a estar predicando nuestro velorio? ¿El Edgar?
Edgar, yeah, you're going to be at my funeral.
I mean, I don't know.
Honestly, I don't want mine to be this kind of tradition that I grew up going to all this stuff. I just want to burn me, put me on the urn,
Earn it.
Do what you want to do. Mm-hmm. Try to sneak me into Disneyland and throw my ashes
I'll
in
get
there.
A little pouch of you. Yeah. I'd get a little pouch and I would sneak it into Disneyland. I'd do it for you.
Thank you.
I'd do it appreciate for you. It.
But then what if it's just like my torso or my toe that just made it to Disneyland?
Well, I'll make sure that they blend you real nice. Get a little piece of all of you.
Actually, that's a good question. How big is the bag like once they cremate it? Is it a lot?
Honestly, like probably around this.
¿Pesará como una libra o no?
It is a little bit heavy. Because my first time checking, like doing an ID check just to make sure we got the right person.
Yeah.
Because like I said, like you have to check that little coin.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
I had to lift up the bag and I thought it was going to be light, but it's actually a little bit heavy. And I was like, oh, shit.
Wow.
Yeah.
Oye, ¿no te ha tocado clientes?
That the body doesn't burn right and it's like half a skull. Like, oh, put it back in the urn.
¿No te ha tocado tener clientes bien paranoicos que quieren que les confirmes que es el...
Oh, like dental records and stuff?
From the time that I've been there, no.
¿Te imaginas un cliente me paran? Hey, so how do I know this is my husband?
Oh, he dead. He really dead. I made sure.
But how do I... ¿Cómo sé que no quemaste un perro y me estás dando las cenizas de un perro ahorita?
That's true.
Well,
so yeah. For a situation like that...
Take pictures?
The coin.
Oye.
Because the coin it's placed right... with the body.
What?
Nah. Ya quiero llegar a las preguntas importantes.
Oh, yeah, I'm sorry.
Ya todos...
We're running kind of long now. Wait, because of this topic.
Ya todos, nadie está escuchando ahorita. ¿Me puedes conseguir un pedazo de carne humana?
Oh my God, Mickey. No. I remember this conversation.
¿Me puedes conseguir un pedazo de carne o no?
No. Look, listen.
No
lo
interrumpas, quiero que me digas.
Wait, hold on. Let him finish.
¿Me puedes conseguir un pedazo de carne?
No.
¿Eh? No te dejan.
No.
Listen.
Un dedo.
Look, we can't Mickey, just... I hate
how your face looks right now. You look so disappointed.
We have to angle it a little differently. Do you know a guy that preps these bodies that can get us a slice on the DL?
Don't do it.
I do not.
Si algún día te topas... Javi. Si algún día te topas con una buena palanca para conseguir carne, avísame, ¿ok? Javi, si te topas con una opción o alguien que... Algún maniático ahí que me pueda conseguir una nalga o algo acá. ¿Qué tendrá mejor
carne? We'll be the best part of the
es lo que te voy a preguntar.
Ribs. ¿Qué tal? Costillitas.
No, si me puedes conseguir unas costillas de humano para hacer barbecue aquí afuera, me avisas, ¿no?
Here's the thing, though. Because there's not a lot of experience of people eating bodies, you have to kind of guess how it's going to be prepared. Because not every...
Okay.
Because you know how, like, you prepare, like, pork differently than you prepare beef?
Oh.
So you have to consider...
Experimentar.
You have to consider that you have... You're going to... It's a trial and error. So you're going to need a lot of meat to, like, find the right good cut of meat, you know?
Yo! It's right here. Our prayers have been answered, I guess.
All
right. Let's see.
Oh, shit.
What?
Let's see this. Hold on. Let's see.
Half your body...
let me go a little bit back. Sorry.
Can you get half your body cremated and the other half buried? Do morticians do that? Asking for a friend. I have never done that, and I've never had anybody ask... I guess I could see it happening if you really wanted to. You would have to have a disposition permit that would have cremation and burial. And I guess we'd probably have to sign a waiver to cut someone in half. But maybe the bigger question would be, what half are you going to cremate and what half do you bury?
That's a good question.
That's pretty good.
This is a question.
I mean, it's
lengthwise. Pues, right down the middle.
O sea, pónganme...
One arm, one leg. Like, you know, like when you go to buy chicken, you can get like dark meat and light meat. You're like, this.
A huevo.
Así, just...
pónganme en una table saw y atraviesenme por la mitad.
Table saw.
Wait. But one... I have one request.
Okay.
Push the duh to the side. Push the dill to the side that is not gonna get cremated, okay?
Hey, pero es un huevo y un huevo.
No. No, todo completo, okay?
Un huevo y un huevo.
Okay, un huevo, pero la salchicha mándenla para el lado de la... Pónganla para el lado que no va a estar quemada.
These are the real questions.
Yeah.
Wowzers.
I like how.
Think, wait. So which, are you going to bury the duh? Or are you going to burn the duh?
No. I want to bury the duh. Oh, okay. Aparte, cuando entierren esa mitad, la vamos a poner así como de lado para que se mire. Como, para que parezca. Oh. Checa, gordo. En un espejo. La cama es un espejo.
Okay.
Van a enterrarme de lado en un espejo. Entonces cuando la gente se asome así,
you're gonna plaster your body to a mirror. So
entonces cuando lo mires vas a ver como que está completo, ¿ves? Aparte de eso, más simétrico, más guapo, más guapo.
More symmetrical.
¿Qué no?
Man.
If you come back as a ghost with that half body,
then I come back as a ghost.
Otra cosa, entiérrenme de la mitad para acá porque esta rodilla es la mala, ¿pues me entiendes? Quemen la rodilla mala, por favor.
Yeah. Burn the bad knee.
No, yeah. Just for that, like, you know what? Screw Mickey. Let's bury the
bed. Hey, the guy at the mortuary. Wait, so did he want the left or the right?
I don't know. Me.
And they mess you up. They mess you up, dude.
Yeah.
Well, that was very dark and twisted.
Yeah, and I like how the previous episode, Gordo, you're like, hey, let's be more.
we'll clean it up in the sense of like language.
We just literally talked about was just so bad. Anyway, yeah. I just wanted to state it.
Amazing.
That's hilarious.
Hey, cuando nomás dos cosas. En 6 meses, si aguantaste en ese jale, vente y luego cuéntame todo lo que aprendiste.
Definitely come back.
Yeah. La segunda, consígueme la carne esa que te pedí.
That very, very, very hard to find meat.
Just go to the store and buy a meat. He's not gonna tell the difference.
Let me out, Husky!
Let's wrap it up.
Wait, do we have anything else before we can move?
Oh, go on. You want to plug in your stuff?
Yeah, do you want to plug in your stuff, your socials?
What?
Your social medias, your Instagrams, your YouTubes,
Oh, no, I'm good.
You have an Instagram for your car?
I don't. Not yet.
Why not?
¿No tienes una página para tus carros?
No, not yet.
Debería de tener una, ¿no?
He will, though. Once he puts the waifu sticker on it.
Yeah.
Oye, once the whole rap is done.
Ahí te va una pregunta. ¿Cómo le llaman cuando este no es una etapa? ¿Cómo se dice en inglés? Cuando dice this is not a phase.
Oh yeah, it's not a phase, mom.
¿Dirías que esto es un phase que se te va a pasar o te gusta?
Es tu estilo. Is it a lifestyle?
La neta. Dime la neta.
I think a lifestyle.
¿Tú crees?
Yeah.
Estás bastante morrito, yo pienso, para no estar seguro.
Who knows? Maybe.
Got him.
Well, at the very least, you're gonna make some great memories.
So, yeah. Entonces te haz una página para tu carro para que cuando tengas a tus hijos en 40 años y les digas.
If later on I want to be embarrassed of the car how I wrapped it, then.
Hey son, did I ever tell you about the time that I wrapped my car in anime boobs? Yeah, it was pretty
Dad,
hot.
Dad, what's hentai?
Oh. Next question.
moving on.
Play me out, Husky.
That's pretty funny.
Play me out.
Oh. All right. Well, hey, Javi, thank you for being on the show, man.
Yeah.
It was a lot. Very informational.
Let me just say that we appreciate you, and I'm actually glad that you are part of the crew now.
You're one of the boys.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
No, mames.
I saw my veins.
Get that.
I guess just follow us on Instagram and Twitter at Hey Plebes.
Hey Plebes, subscribe to the YouTube y todo lo que quieran si quieren saber en 6 meses qué está pasando con esta.
We need subs on YouTube.
Si quieres saber a qué sabe la carne en la mana, ¿cómo se dice?
Yeah, we won't even say that it was him that brought it to
mantente
us.
Mantente conectado aquí el si
mystery
quieres,
meat. Like I'll lunch.
I'll tell you what's the best way to prepare it.
Yes. And also, we already know at Hey Plebes on Instagram and Twitter. Instagram is going to be popping. YouTube is going to be popping. We're going to do the live stream. So stay tuned for that. And other than that, guys, have a great day.